good, because this is a kind of experimental concert.
And over the winter, I did lots of changes to the harp in the way that it sounds, so to give it a more medieval sound. And so that's why I'm having a go at the really hardcore medieval music out of the medieval manuscripts. As a kind of experiment to see how it works, to see if it's really true or not, that the harp's better now, or if it was a great big mistake and I have to undo everything and get back to how it was last year. So I'm going to play just a selection of the medieval tunes, a lot of them from local medieval manuscripts. So we'll start really local with the cathedral music book, just from down the road to the cathedral ruins. And this is a hymn to St Andrew himself. I'm not going to sing it, but I'll play it out of the book on the harp. Song for St Silin, and I just think St Silin is a very interesting saint. I don't know anything about him, it's very local and regional, but he has this grand instrumental variation set dedicated to him, and it's very big and very geometrical. There's 12 variations, and they're a little bit like the architecture of a cathedral Or perhaps like the decorated pages in a gospel book. You look at the page, you know, like in the Book of Kells, and all you see is a giant cross, and it's all very complicated. You look closer, and you see the cross is made up of little panels. And you look at each panel is like tiles, and you look at a tile, and each tile is a kind of grid of interlace, and you look at one of the strands of interlace, and you realize it's a tiny animal's foot. And then you look back out, and you see it's probably hundreds and hundreds of beads. Do you see what I mean? It's this kind of, every layer is depths of structure, and that's what we see in this music. So there'll be 12 variations, and each variation has the same kind of pattern inside it, but it develops very slowly. And then there's a little refrain that separates each one so you can keep track of where we are. Thank you. continue with another vocal piece from the St Andrews Cathedral music book. And I chose this one partly because it's a nice melody and partly because I like its political, international theme. It's a kind of biblical allegory on the murder of Thomas Beckett. So it's picking up on hot political things, on the scene in England and France. And I'm not quite sure how they would have used it in the liturgy, but I guess you have politics in the liturgy in medieval cathedrals. I don't know. It's just very interesting. So the text, basically, the title means in Rama was heard the weeping. So it uses all these biblical characters, but you're meant to obviously guess that each of them refers to Thomas and the king and the king of France and this kind of thing. So it tells the story. But because each of the actual political players is identified as a biblical person, there's instantly a lot of moral judgment on who's right and who's wrong. You know which side you're on. Books in Ireland, but what you do get, especially in the early times, is when all the Irish missionaries were going across to Europe, they took a lot of Irish and Celtic chants with them. And so this one, called Ibunt Sancti, I haven't come across it at all in an Irish manuscript or in a Scottish manuscript, but you do get it on the continent. But the reason this one interests me is because of all the stories connected with it. It's a very little chant, it only has two lines. But for some reason, the Celtic saints were very fond of this one, so there's all kinds of stories. So, for example, when St Columba came across to Scotland, and there was a famous meeting between Columba and Kentigern, the apostles of the Picts and the Scots, and they had a great meeting somewhere near Glasgow, and St Columba's monks sang Ibunt Sancti. I don't remember what Kentigern's monks sang, but you know, this confab. And the other story that's even more fascinating is St Brendan, who is the famous wandering monk. He made a little boat, like a hide boat, and set off onto the sea and sailed out into the Atlantic and found all kinds of fabulous places. They landed one night on a little island and there was a fire, and the island woke up because it was the back of a whale, you know, that kind of adventure. And at the far other edge of the Atlantic, where you get to fabulous places, they came to an island where there were three choirs in a great monastery, and they sang Ibunt Sancti all day and all night. And I think that's so interesting. It's a little chart with two lines. How do you keep it going all day and all night? So we'll try now. I'm not going to keep going all day and all night, but I'm just going to improvise variations and we'll see where we end up. Thank you.
Thank you.
Salve, splendor, et patrone, iubant et justitiae, orthodoxe doctrine pastor, et thank you.